So just before I show you some of the details up close, I wanted to give you a sense and sort of overview of how the boards are starting to look together and some of the differences from this perspective with the second board that I've done and the original board. So a quick couple changes. First, I decided to try a new wave against the shore, and because as they start to break, right, they get a little smaller and conform to the shore. So I tried that out, and I like the effect overall, and I get to sort of tweak it on the upcoming boards, but not in a way that, you know, will clash with this board. But perhaps the biggest change really that you'll see over the boards is how I've handled the foam between the waves and the shore and coming off. If you recall, I was kind of concerned about the corner of the waves and how the foam was coming off of it. So I actually went back, stared at some more video, stared at some more pictures, and realized that in fact the foam coming off of the waves actually tends to form a bit of a point. Now, without getting into too much, my suspicion is that as it moves forward, right, these bubbles are popping and new ones are being produced, and so it forms a bit of this taper. So I've done that on these, and because of the way I had laid down some of the color on this one, I wasn't able to really taper these, but I don't really think it's that big of a difference, and, you know, I think it's going to work just fine. The other big change that you may notice is that I've added in a sort of wet sand area, and I was really unsure. I thought I'd have to go to Envirotex and mix that up and rub it into the sand, and what I found out is that I can take the caulking material, I'm using Liquid Nails Clear Seal, and by thinning that quite a bit with some mineral spirits, I could brush it on, and it gives a very, I think, very believable effect for the wet sand. And then I've added in some bits of seaweed scattered about, and I've put some in the shallow areas as well to try to represent, you know, sort of as the seaweed's been broken off, you know, and it's carried in by the surf. And lastly, I've picked this board because it had a rock outcropping, and I really wanted to try to tackle that and see how I do the surge surf. And if you go back and you look at my Surf 101 video where I did a lot of research, this is a slightly different effect of waves than the, you know, types of spilling waves that we have along here. Now, one of the things that was a bit of a challenge with this, at least for me conceptually, is how to handle the amount of whitewater around the rock, particularly on the backside. And I think I've gone just a little too aggressive on it, although my wife came over and said she liked it, so I'll take that as a positive. But I think having some breaks in this would be a little bit more appropriate, and there is foam behind it when you look at some of these rocks in, you know, in the natural world, but I think it's just a little bit too choppy, and we'll see that when we come up close to it. Overall, I feel pretty solid about this, the way they're matching up. Now you'll notice that I have the waves sort of coming this direction and coming this direction. I'm going to stay true to that because they really bend to the shore, and as they come in, they actually roll to meet the shoreline. Now technically, right, we should have it kind of coming in straight and then forming perhaps a shape like this, but I can't guarantee that other boards are going to match up the same way to this, and getting that froth to cover both of these. I just don't feel confident that I can manage that. So what I've decided to do instead is to just take each board individually and then have them progressing on their own direction. And I think it works all right. So I'm okay with that. But that would be one of those little things I could change if it was going to be, say, a static set. I think that could be a little bit better. So having said all of that, let's come over to the bench, and I'm going to show you some of the improved details in the waves, a little closer in the froth. Of course, this rock, and we'll compare it a bit to some of the older material that I put down. So, in the interest of trying to make video recording a little easier, I didn't actually bring the lights over on this, so I bumped up the ISO for this shot so that I could extend the depth of field. So if it looks a little noisy, meaning there's grain in the film, I'll see when I edit it. That's why, and that's something I'll address in a future video if it looks unsatisfactory to me, of course. So, just to give you a little sense of what has been going on, actually, let me just lock the focus so we don't have it getting all crazy here. What I've done is I've done more work trying to get this curl coming over on top of the, you know, the edge of the wave as it's falling. And I think I did a much better job on this. Of course, I didn't really have much of this on the first board, but I'm liking it quite a bit. There's probably a little tweaking I can do in there, but overall, I'm excited with the modification, and I think it just improves it quite a bit. The other thing I did with this wave is I realized that when you look at spilling, that the waves frequently don't always break in the same spot, and then as the wave comes in, a new break forms, and it'll kind of all unify as it approaches to the shore. So I wanted to do a little test piece, a little section there, just to see how that might look, how that might feel. And I like it a lot. You know, I kept it small. Whenever I do something new, I try to be conservative with it. But I think it just adds a little bit more realism to the feel of the movement of the ocean. And that is something I will definitely be incorporating in more detail as, you know, the boards progress. So also, you can get a little sense, and we'll come up super close on this just so you can see what's going on here, but you get a little sense of how the froth looks now. When I took a look at the froth of actual shorelines, what I noticed is that it's a much broader pattern than what I had originally done, and it has, but it still has a bit of a, like a net pattern, maybe that's the best way to describe it. So it has these sort of lines of foam that kind of coalesce, leaving some areas that are a little bit more clear. So what I've been doing actually is sort of lightly striking in a little line of the caulking that's been tinted white. And then I go in and I stipple it lightly with some of the frit that I showed you earlier in another video that I've used for the texture of the sand, leaving it white, of course. And I think that kind of gives a nice effect. It's a little bit, I think, I'd have to do a lot of practicing, I think, in new techniques. I feel like it's just a little too soft, too, I don't know what the word to use is, blobby maybe. I think it's okay. And in fact, it's a vast improvement over what I had done on the first attempt. So I really am excited about it. But it's probably one of those areas that I would want to really sit down with and play. But I'm already, as you can imagine, I'm going too long on this project. So I'm trying to maintain some kind of a pace on it and maybe pick up the pace as I go forward. The last thing before we take a look at a couple of these areas up close is I've also been able to create the sort of wet line where the water has sloshed, and I really like how that worked out, and it was easier to do than I thought. So now I have this really nice transition, right, where it's the heavy water, then we have the wet sand, and some of the thicker water as it's moving up or moving back. One of the things, and in fact, let me slide this over. You may wonder, why is this little wave breaking here? It's not intended to be one of these waves coming in, but what I noticed is as the waves dissipated and started to, you know, get back into a sort of uniform foam, the water that's already piled up on the shore, it actually moves backwards, right? It's surging back into the ocean, and that will actually cause another small break to occur. So that's what I'm really trying to model here, and it doesn't have all of the finished detail that these waves have, and I'm moving on beyond it because I think at the end I'm very likely to give one pass over all the boards at the end and do some final touch-ups and make sure that they're all unified in technique. So I'm leaving it as it is right now. Excuse me.
But that's the goal that I tried to achieve there. And couple things, you know, the seaweed isn't quite sitting down the way I'd like it to, so I'll probably go back over that and sit that down. Sit. Oh, look at that. Sit. Be good. All right, but I'll probably add a little sealant there just to make sure it stays down, because it should look wet and kind of matted down. So before, actually, we do close-ups, let's take a look at this from this angle. So again, my mind can only handle so many things on the first run. And what I was really working on with this is thinking about how the water piles up as it approaches the rock, how some of that piling might meet the rock, and to try some new splash effects that might be a little bit more realistic than just having foam piling against it. Because when you look at videos of the water striking the rocks, frequently you get a splash that piles up. Sometimes the splash goes forward, sometimes the splash goes backwards, depending on the shape of the rock and where it strikes it. So I decided to try a couple of those, again, being a little conservative. But looking at this, I have really just a little too much of a trough next to the rock itself, and so I need to, on the next go, give a little bit more piling on this side with a little more variation, and I think that would be a little bit more realistic. I also tried to pre-tint this area underneath to bring it up in color, give it a little bit more green, because actually it's not so much that the ground is more shallow here, but that the churning of the waves is actually incorporating bubbles kind of deeper into the water, and that gives it a little bit more of a light green, or you can see the color a little bit better. So anyway, worked on that. Okay, I think I can do a little better there on the next go. And again, I've done some of the foam similar to how I've done it on the other side of the board, finishing it with some frit to give some fine bubble texture around it. But it doesn't have quite the netting pattern that I think it could have. So again, next rock that I tackle, I think will look a little bit better without, again, you know, really contrasting with this, so they don't look like they're standing apart visually from each other. So let's come in really close, and I'll just show you a couple more elements. So you can really just see, I think, a little bit better. What I tried to do against the rock is add some water, because it foams up against the rock and sloshes back. There's lots of water on the rock and foam, and it was a bit of a challenge to try to get it to show up without looking like a big blob on top of it, right? We have a scale issue here, where if it's sitting up really thick, it's going to look unnatural, and if it's really thin, it's a little bit hard to see. So as I go forward, if I discover a way to bring that effect out a little bit more, I suspect I might be able to come in and touch up some of this area to give it some of that effect. But that was one of the goals, and you can see here, hopefully you can see, I tried to get a little bit of a wet effect without the foam, right, because we have a little bit of both. It'd be nice if I could get a little dripping off of these rocks, as that's really, you know, happening on some of these areas that there's an overhang. I didn't want to get too crazy on this version, as I really had this splashing that I really wanted to tackle. One thing. Hopefully I can keep this all in focus. One thing I wanted to do is have a wave sort of slupping up and over the area of the rock here without actually breaking. And I liked that effect. Oh, is that even in frame? Hold on. All right. There we go. I think we're still in frame here. Or in focus. So, you know, I piled it up here a little bit to give it, you know, the illusion that the water is rising up over the rock that's submerged without actually breaking into a actual, you know, turbulence. And I like that. And I think, you know, again, it's one of these areas. I think I can continue tweaking on the future boards and really get a little bit more out of that. And certainly the different kinds of rocks that are going to be present in the ocean, you know, there's quite a variety of shapes, and that is going to give me some different opportunities to do that. So lastly, before we leave this, is the splashing. So this is actually gauze or something similar. I got this tip from a viewer. Thank you so much. He sent me a link to a video. I cannot remember where the link is. But basically, it's sort of gauze that you add water effects to in a very random pattern. And you can tear it apart and use it as a substructure. They actually use it as it is because it's quite clear. But since these are ocean waves with a lot of froth, you know, basically it's all froth flying up into the air, I wanted to add some of that to it, so I've gone with the opaque white. This one was my second attempt, and I think it looks a little bit more natural. And this one was my first attempt, and let me turn this just a little bit more so we can see it. Okay, hopefully depth of field has been set. Okay, and we'll see. I don't know, in the contrast, we'll see. Hopefully you can see this. Is that I wanted this to come up and back, and it was a bit of a challenge to determine how much, what's the word I'm looking for, volume, amount of spray, the density of the spray. I think I have to go back and look at a few more shots to get it a little bit more accurate. It feels a little bit like coral to me. And that's not exactly the effect I'm looking for. The nice thing is that I could literally just tear this off and put new ones in if I want to. I don't want to do that though, so it's not likely that I'll do that, but it's an option if I feel like I really, really, really want to. And here you can see some of that foam falling off of the rocks. And I think, like, in this area, it looks much better. So in any case, that gives you a sense of how the rock and the surging surf looks. And let's take a quick look at the new waves as well. All right. So here we can see, you know, a little bit of a close-up of that curl. Really, really like how that started to come out, and I'm getting a better feel of how to manage the caulking, because I have to thin it, and when I thin it, there's a balance between it being thick enough to hold its shape and thin enough not to slump, but also not so thick that it sets up too fast, and it's a bit of a trick. I won't even joke around about it. It's not easy. And you may notice how nice and clear it is. As I mentioned in the last video, I thought I would try degassing it, and I was able to. However, I have to thin it more than I'd like, and it is a tricky degassing because it is still so thick. It rises so far, and it's so hard to get the bubbles out of this. That it's the longest period and most challenging degassing I've ever done. But I'm willing to go the extra mile to get that really nice effect, and it just adds, you know, such a nice even transition between these waves and coming forward, and it makes this area where I can push it around so nice and clear, and oh, it's so nice compared to what I was doing before, but oh man, you know, sacrifice of time. And of course, let me see here, I'm just going to push this up a little bit, and I think we can get a good sense of that. Here you can get a better look at some of the foam and how that's looking. And again, I really think it's much, much, much better. And you may wonder why I've got so much, you know, on the boards. When I look at shots of an aggressive, you know, spilling surf on the beach, there's a ton of foam in the water. I mean, a ton. And I did, you know, take it back a little bit here, like as the water is done and it's receding, there's not really as much foam, and then it, you know, gets caught in the wave and gets churned again. And that was something that I was trying to actually incorporate here. You may think that this is actually supposed to be caused by this wave breaking, but no, they really don't start leaving foam until they look a little lower. But this is foam, in my mind at least, that has been, you know, washing back, and then the waves pick it back up. So that was the effect I was trying to get. So that's a look at these waves. Let me show you the original ones just so you can see how the modification to them worked out. So this was originally the area that was all, you know, I literally hand drew in the foam with paint, and I was able to strip off the top layer of paint, but there was you know, a color underneath in a lower layer. So what I had to do was to make sure I covered that lower layer as much as I could to blend it visually with the other board. And it's given it a little bit more texture than I like, but it's really only going to be noticeable under a very careful eye. So, you know, it's I felt good about the, you know, the sort of bringing it in alignment with the other board. You know, you can see there's a little, you know, rise in some of these areas, which, you know, it's not necessarily out of line, but it's, you know, it's a little more than probably should be there. And one of the things here is another example of a wave I haven't quite finished, but I'm going to leave it for now because it really needs a little bit more of the sort of dryish looking foam applied to the top of this, giving it a little bit more aggressive frothing. That's all right. That'll be not too difficult at the very end. And lastly, this area, wait a minute, keep going, there we go. This area was the real, I don't want to call it, well, it's kind of an eyesore, where I had the sort of a sharp delineation in the foam coming off of the shore here. So one of the nice things is I was able to go back in and smooth that out, because I said there's so much foam on the shoreline, I was able to really carry that out and blend that in and kind of fix that area. So that was a nice change there. Now, one thing you may notice is that if you're looking carefully, you'll see that this color here is just a little bit off from the first board that I showed you. This is because hold on, that's an alarm to warn me I'm going long. I'll see in editing how that happens, if I can cut that out. But you'll see here that this has got just a hair of a tint of blue more than the other caulking that I was using. This is actually I can't remember the brand. I think it's DAP Crystal Clear. DAP is not crystal clear. Don't let them fool you. In a thicker volume, it actually picks up a blue hue, and that is what has been happening when I've said in the past in my ocean boards that there was blue in the water that I didn't anticipate. So what I've done actually is I've gone over some of these areas with the new color to sort of smooth that out and knock down the blue just a hair, and it helps. You know, as soon as I noticed that, I was like, that's done. That's done. I'm only using Liquid Nails Clear Sill from now on, and it's really hard to get. And so I think I'm going to try and buy like a 5-year supply of it, because I'm afraid it's going to be discontinued at any time. I just ordered 20 tubes of it to make sure I have enough for this project. Don't go away from me, Crystal Clear, because I really want to have a true clear color so that it actually matches whatever the underside resin is. So anyway, I think I started to get a little rambly there, but that gives you a look of how I'm doing some of the water, the wet areas of the shore, and of course the froth and the modifications to the waves. So let's wrap it up.
So that gives you a look at the ocean boards and where they're at. I'm going to be settling down now and trying to crank them out now that I've gotten that final research sort of element done. Of course, around the rocks is going to be a little different. Plus, I have the cliffs to do for the islands. But, I have a good vision of how that's going to work. So we'll see. I'm going to try and put in some extra hours. It's tough in the summer. I know it's not technically the summer, but it sort of is, because I've got all these other things that are competing for my time. But I'm focused, or getting focused. And of course, you probably already noticed the mic card got full. So I haven't done it yet, but I already have, according to you, mic'd over sections of the video rather than reshoot them. I think that's gonna be a little bit easier. So hopefully you can forgive me for that. Data management, it's its own thing. Anyway, stay tuned to the channel, of course. Questions and comments always welcome down below. And I've got bunch of stuff to shoot. Absolutely a bunch of stuff. So I'm going to try and rip out a few and have them in the bank so I can edit them over the next few days and release them over that time. So hopefully you will come back and join me again, because you know I will be back soon with another TerranScapes video.